Hello, everybody. This is Derek L. Mitchell. And today, I want to give you a message that I've been wanting to speak on for about 2 weeks now, ever since the Super Bowl. Now, I waited a while because immediately after the game, after such a stunning upset, I know that people were disappointed. I know that I was. Emotions were running high and very intensely. But it's been 2 weeks now, things have calmed down a little, and I think that you are ready to receive this message, and I'm very ready to give it to you as well. And that message is, winners win. Now, immediately after that game, I had an epiphany, and something became very clear and apparent to me. And that was something that I had heard from one of my favorite speakers, Dr. Eric Thomas. And he said something in a video a few months ago that I understood in theory, but watched it unfold in reality during that game. So take a quick look.
Not a victim. Now let me say this before I move forward, and I can't explain it, but you better feel me. Winners win and losers lose. I can't explain it any better than that. I don't know how it happens, but winners win.
That's right. He said, winners win. Now before I go any further, I have to point out that the Falcons are not losers in my book. They proved that they weren't losers over this past season and in the last game, regardless of the outcome and the final score. But at the same time, while they proved that they weren't losers, Tom Brady and the Patriots proved that they are winners and that winners win against impossible odds and obstacles. Winners can and do win. Why is that? Winning and getting the victory and a trophy and an accolade, that's not what makes a winner. The actual win is just a public result and consequence of the internal and private victory of building a winner's mindset and identity. It's about who you know you are, not just who you think you are or portray yourself to be in front of people, but deep down who you know you are. And Tom Brady knew that he was a winner. So what else could he do except win? I believe that we all act accordingly to our identity. So a fighter will eventually find a fight. A servant will eventually find somebody to help and serve. A protector will find someone to protect. And the winner will find a way to win. Do you think that Tom Brady forgot who he was and his identity as a result of what was on that scoreboard at halftime? Do you think that Tom Brady forgot about those four rings that he has in a case somewhere just because they were down to 25 points? You think that the Patriots as a whole forgot about their record and reputation just because they had a rough start to an important good aim? They didn't. Those are just temporary conditions and circumstances of life. Those don't stop you from being a winner. because if you know that you are a winner, you can overcome those. So right now, if your checking account doesn't say what you want it to, or your career is not on the track that you expected, or you can't get any funding or investors for your business, that doesn't make you a loser. If you believe and know that you are a winner, those are just temporary circumstances and life conditions to overcome. And eventually, that winner's identity and mindset will push you to figure out a way to overcome any and everything to eventually do what a winner does, and that is win. Now, there's one more thing that I want you to consider. I know oh, many of us were disappointed with that loss, and that's okay. But I know that a lot of us are also losing in our personal lives at this present moment. And I want you to think about how disappointed and upset you felt when the Falcons came short. Is that the same way that you felt when you have suffered a recent loss in your life? How did you feel when you didn't get the promotion that you wanted, or the loan or investment that you were expecting, or didn't get accepted into the school or the program that you were aiming for, or fell short on reaching a goal that you set for yourself? If you felt more upset about your team losing than you losing, then that's an issue and your priorities are out of order. I need you to be as invested in your success as you are in the success of your team. Winners are invested in their success and invest in themselves. So when you lose, I need you to be as disappointed as you were when your team lost. I know that we rise up for our city and our team and expect the same in return, but I want you to rise up for yourself, for your own dreams, your own goals, and rise up from your own losses in your own life. At the end of the day, we all fall in two categories with the thin line right down the middle. Either you are getting what you want out of life, not getting what you want, or still deciding which category you will ultimately fall in. Winners win, losers lose, and the rest are just figuring out. Now, I want you to think about this next question very seriously and answer absolutely honestly. Which one are you? I'll see you next time.